This is YPD Walls aboard 2K18 News. We're going to go back into the proving grounds, you know, the creator player. And we're still stuck on the point guard position. We haven't really felt to do the footage of release isn't. It's only other point guard position that I received. We're gonna go with the playmaker, which is passing the ball handling. You see the secondary skill is 3-point shooting. Look at the badges. You know, you got the dimer. Basically got the regular playmaker badges, but it's not Hall of Fame. It's more gold, but you get, I think, 9 silver, I believe, and 5 bronze. But you can look at the different attributes, cap and 3-point shooting. It's a secondary badge. And then whenever you move forward to the next badge, which would be basically a pure playmaker, you can see the ball handling and the passing is all the way up. And before the ball handling, the passing, it wasn't all the way up. And you see you got your 5 Hall of Fame badges, because of course you get Hall of Fame badges whenever you make a pure score, but I also understand, I also noticed that they get 5 Hall of Fame badges whenever I was doing the shooter. The point guard, I think passing or defender shooter, they only have 4 Hall of Fame badges. Or the defending point guard, which was primary skill defending, secondary skill was defending. Also, they only had 4 Hall of Fame badges. But if you see defending, it kind of takes away, when you make your secondary skills as a defending, it kind of takes away from your ball handling and passing. It's still good, but it's not the elite level that I know most playmakers in the game actually want, since they like to, you know, if you want to be a dribble guy, it wouldn't be best for you to make a passing and ball handling defending playmaker. And the post scorer, this doesn't even make sense to me of why would a person make a point guard post passing and ball handling basically in their secondary as post scoring. I mean, it really doesn't make sense to me. I mean, you get 9 gold badges, but I really understand the purpose of that, to make that type of build. But you never know, people make funky builds in this game all the time, so that may be something that catches people for surprise. Now, this is an actual interesting build. It's the rebounding. You might as well call it the playmaker. It's interesting just because I know you're going to have a hustle rebounder gold and put back king gold. But once again, I mean, you can look at the attributes and, you know, they're not too great as far as the verticals. Not even the rebound is really not great. It's just taken away from what you really want, which is the ball handling and passing. So I wouldn't see no point in making that. Now, this is basically a driving playmaker who could finish at the rim at the 1 Hall of Fame badge, which is ankle breaker. And I'm sure those the other gold badges would be posterizer and such. But this is actually decent. You know, you still got your speed, your acceleration, you know, you got your ball handling, but your passing is down a lot, you know. But this is something else maybe to watch out for, you know, that somebody else, that a person may actually make. And your shot creating, see, this don't make sense to me. The shot creating, it seemed like when you make a secondary build with this, it takes away from what you're really good at, what you want to be good at with this position, which is the passing and the ball handling. If it's not a pure passer and ball handler, it's gonna take away from what you want. But I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll be dropping more heat for you.